see.
Do you want me to take her so you can get your glasses?
Multiple things in my hands. So. So with this game, I'll show you what I mean. I like to have two balls if I can. You can do this with one ball. It's easier to do with two. Are you ready?
Yeah, I definitely know her energy spurts, and like I know when I come home from work,
started, roughly. Mm-hmm. So the plague sort of pump is when you have two of these or more. Is it three or two? I haven't done it for a while. It's two. You have them go get one, come towards you, and then as they come towards you, you say come and throw it through your legs.
And then
you have to teach them to sit. Too. So that's where the traditional
comes in. They're not going to chase it? Yeah. Interesting.
That just starts the process of getting towards
first step, Russia.
I know, because she likes to run away. Like if I get the leash out and she knows we're not going to do something fun.
Yeah.
You know, that's awesome. always throw games in there with my dogs because, you know, we have to do work, so.
Yeah.
That's kind of, I mean, I enjoy it because I enjoy working with my dogs, but it is kind of repetitive and boring. It gets dry.
Yeah, I can totally see that.
And so if you throw some games in and they're doing that at other times when they're having fun, then you just make the whole experience so much better.
Hold on.
Little bit of healing.
Yes.
A lot of work.
Yep. Ivor's a very nice dog, though.
Have
you
sit?
Ivor,
sit. Good girl.
Good girl.
Okay. It's my daughter, Shannon.
And does she know the biggest distraction for Piper is his hand?
Yeah.
It is.
She loves
me. Oh,
good girl. Not even so much the dogs. I'll like finally get her settled down around the dogs and then Robert comes up.
Seriously. Yeah.
She also likes our tenant next door, Steve.
Yeah. Who's like? Hey, is it?
Take this. There you go.
Don't
forget to release her.
Yeah. Okay.
There you go.
So, Jennifer, was she biting at anybody at all?
Biting at us?
At anybody.
She, not at people. Not like hard enough to hurt. Like she'd be playing.
Well, right. So.
Aaron, my son, he would play rough with her. And he would get on the floor and be like another puppy and play with it. I would tell him not to do that, but I think
she would mouth.
But what I call mouthing, not really biting, because there's no force into it.
Right.
Yeah. So but as far as like the what you had said or somebody had said about getting her in the crate, we never had a problem getting her in the crate.
Yeah, I actually, the first few days, I had to put myself behind here because I didn't know her.
No.
She would just go in on her own.
Well, I don't think it was a crate as much as it
just being strange person,
reaching for her.
Yeah, no, never.
Coming down.
Putting down the chain collar.
Is she doing it? Is she sleeping in there?
No.
So maybe it was just a trust thing.
Yeah,
I think that's
I'm sure,
what it was.
Yeah.
Yeah,
she's
it was
never
good
done that.
For her, has she ever been with real strangers trying to grab her?
Well, she's had, no, I'm not trying to grab her. We have a lot of people coming in and out of our house, and she's always been very, she loves people.
Right.
But
no one's
trying
to go down and
grab. No, besides
she
us.
She doesn't like that.
Yeah.
Or she did.
She's fine with us doing it. Maybe she's fine with you doing it.
No, she is. Yeah. But I'm saying, like, it's good to do that because when she goes to the vet, how does she do there?
She's fine, but I'm there with her.
Yeah.
Yeah, she's fine.
So, I mean, like, it could be, like, if they take her in the back room to give her a shawl or something like that.
Yes,
I
mean,
I just
want to complain.
Warn them.
Well, she has, we've already done that. She, matter of fact, she just got shots before we came, and they never said anything.
Let's say, like, you had a dog walker, or you ordered
him. We do have a dog walker, and she's never had a problem. She's,
maybe
she's
she
never,
just hates us.
No, you know what? Also remember, this is a new area. Like, at home, it's her territory. She feels comfortable. And the vet, she's been enough times. She knows the vet, also. She's been there since she was, puppy.
Yeah, it was just the first couple of days.
Okay.
And I think it was just that she was a little bit unsure about who we were and what we were.
And that was a bit of a challenge at first. I wanted to make sure that she really had nothing behind it before I just...
Right.
And I'm sure that nobody was bossing her around as much as we were the first couple of days.
Right. That's probably true, too.
So she could have been
like, no.
Yeah. I'm over this.
No. No, thank you.
But it's been a while since she's done that, right?
Yeah.
It was only the first couple of days.
Okay, good.
But now when you go for her, she wants to kiss you.
Yeah. Yeah, that's what we experienced.
Yeah, and now she just walks in. Every now and then she'll give me, like, if she sees me walking towards the crate, she'll just run and do the play by and everything.
I do sometimes bribe her. I mean, a lot of times she goes to the crate on her own, but because she likes her crate at home. But sometimes when I'm in a hurry and I need to get her in, I don't have to. I'll take a little treat and throw it up there.
Because if she knows that you want to kind of corral her, then she starts to get a little bit like turning around trying to mouth at you,
Interesting. Okay.
But not anymore.
She just doesn't want to.
I try and growl at her every chance I get.
Yeah, because it's good to get if you have a
right to get
her. Growl
at
her feet,
grab
her tail.
Yeah, like now I always make sure
I'll
go just to make sure she's.
She's okay with
you. Yeah, just to make sure she's okay with it. Robin tried to work with her before I did, so she kind of warned me about it, so I was like,
That wasn't letting my work.
My chances are
to
do it.
Well, I didn't have to do it until I figured out what she was doing, Then when I felt her, like, rubbing hips against my
Yeah, yeah. So she didn't actually, she didn't.
No, she didn't bite, but yeah. she, you know.
She was, right.
If it precipitated.
Yeah.
The video kept challenging.
Right.
And you just kept on pushing her, you know?
Well, let me ask
you. That's good. That's a warning. I always appreciate warning.
Yeah, there you go. So let me ask you. So my 13-year-old Aaron, which you guys met, he does that rough play with her, and then he wants it to stop, and she wants to keep going. And so is that...
It's probably better for him to have more constructive, structured play.
Structured play with her, okay.
She has before he starts to do that, he should work with her on commands.
Okay.
So in the middle of that, he should be able to give her a command.
That makes a lot of sense. Person what?
Personally, I don't like rough play with dogs. Like, Russell kind of play with dogs anyways.
Especially with a dog that has a propensity.
Yeah, that's what I was concerned about because of her breed mix.
Not so much her breed, but just like we'd say when somebody reaches for her.
Yeah.
Or when she's moving quickly, you try and grab for her,
right.
Or something like that, that's when she has the most
bite
ambition.
You just look in.
But she does have a very nice, lovely temper.
She's really nice. You're a
sweetie,
huh?
See, in her leg, her getting pink, too, I see. I think she knows we're leaving.
She's pinking up?
Yeah.
That's a nipple. A nipple!
You know, I was looking at these bumps and they almost look scaly, almost like she's got eczema or something. You know, maybe just being in a different environment can stress.
Yeah.
I don't stress the dog out. But I know you're a good man. It was funny. Robin went downstairs and I was calling her. She followed Robin. She snubbed her mommy.
Well, she's been around a lot.
They all love me. They all have like going home too. There's advantages to that.
Yeah. All right. Well, thank you, both of you, for everything you're doing for her and with her. I feel really good about it.
We love her.
Yeah, I feel really good about it.
She's pretty awesome.
Say goodbye.
Are you guys going to the beach tonight?
Yeah, we're going to go to Salisbury, though, on our way home. It's just closer home, and we might meet up with her boyfriend, too. So.
You don't like George?
I'm not a fan of York. We had fun the short scene. We had fun that day.
The long change is right here.
Yeah. And I would do that. We're meeting somebody closer into where we live, so that's why we're doing the Salisbury. No, York was great that day for the boys because they had all
short,
going out
the honky tonk.
But there's no, you know, it's like the waves and the, you know, it's like a little.
No waves, short sand.
Yeah.
Right. A long chance, we were in the biggest waves we've ever been there with that little Ziggy. Careful.
Yeah,
well,
so what are you doing?
He's kind of cute, isn't he?
He is a sweetie. We heard his story.
We heard a miraculous recovery. You're so lucky.
Yep, Ziggy showed up.
That's what she said.
He didn't.